This is the King of Dong Style, the man bringing Sleazy back to professional wrestling, Joey Ryan.
What's up, guys? It is your favorite hot mess, Chelsea Green.
That's right. It's me again, your 24-year-old piece of gold, Leo Rush.
And you're watching the hottest,
the most iconic e-fed in the world,
HKW.
HKW Wrestling.
HKW Wrestling. Enjoy.
Evan, it seems the rest of your little faction are nowhere to be found. But
what?
I'm here, and they're gone, so I want to introduce you to somebody now that it's the Corey Tombstone Show.
For the courage I possess through the drama. H is for the hurt, but it's all for the honor. A is for my attitude, working through the patience. Money comes and goes, so the M is for motivation. Gotta stay consistent, the P is to persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O is optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary, cause I'm never giving up. See, they ask me how I did it, I just did it from the heart. Crushing the competition, been doing it from the start. They say that every champion is all about his principles. Carry.
Try and go over everything that happened this past Sunday at the Royal Gauntlet. On his way down to the ring, you see the Alpha Angel, Ryan Mead. and no doubt Alpha Angel out here to address what happened there at the end of the Royal Gauntlet, that brutal assault by TWE that took out Evan Jones. Unfortunately, Evan Jones has been forced to vacate the HKW Championship following that brutal assault. And that means coming up at Broken Hearts, we are going to have ourselves an Elimination Chamber match to crown a new champion.
This past week in HKW, each and every one of you bore witness to an absolute travesty, a crime committed right here in this very ring. Everybody here, everyone at home, everyone saw it clear as day. Xander Shaw was done. It was over. And then somehow I get screwed out of my internet championship. Despair walks away with my internet championship.
Are you serious?
No. Despair, quite frankly, is no better than those cowardly asshats from TWE. And after the events of the Royal Gauntlet, after Evan Jones was robbed of the HKW Championship, not because he didn't win the Royal Gauntlet, you all saw that he did. No, it's because once again, TWE wants to get involved in HKW business. Well, enough is enough. The EFED Elite are going to set things right, and it's going to start right here tonight. So Despair, I don't know where your ass is in the back, but you better hide, boy, because I'm coming to find you and get my belt back, and I'm going to do it right now.
Well, the Alpha Angel looks like he's going to go hunting for Despair, the HKW Internet Champion. Meanwhile, we have a great show set for you tonight. The HKW Undisputed Women's title going to be on the line. We're going to see stars like Rock Leone, the HKW United States Champion, and Ian King in action. And heading down to the ring, making his singles match return.
Making his way to the ring.
He is New York, the high flyer known as Aaron L. Bronson. Aaron Bronson making his shocking return to HKW at the Royal Gauntlet event. I'm sure the former HKW champion disappointed that he didn't come away with the gold, but coming up at Broken Hearts, who knows, he may get another opportunity. Evan Jones forced to vacate the championship, and that means at Broken Hearts, we're gonna have ourselves a Elimination Chamber match to crown a new HKW champion. I know that Aaron Bronson has been lobbying for a qualifier match to get into that Elimination Chamber. Looking to make a big return here to the HKW. And he's been told he will get himself a qualifier. That is, if he can get past the kaiju, the monster, known as Jason.
Weighing in at 332 pounds, the monster, Jason!
Jason getting a little unlucky at the Royal Gauntlet drawing number two. the first two men inside the squared circle, along with Cameron Logan Mindhunter, who also made a shocking return at the Gauntlet. Not only entering at number one, but also replacing CJ Mundo after another one of those TWE attacks. Both Mundo and Evan spending some time in the hospital. We're wishing both of them a speedy recovery. And here we go, Aaron Bronson and the Monster Jason, and immediately Jason using the height advantage, trying to get that face lock applied to Bronson. Bronson with shots to the gut, drilling Jason into the corner. Here comes Bronson with a series of strikes. Aaron Bronson never been too worried about getting inside the ring with a guy bigger than him, but Jason, well, there's a reason we call him a monster. Whoa! And it shows a strength like that, twisting Bronson around like a sack of potatoes. Aaron Bronson still on the offensive, not backing down. Snapmare takeover by Jason, and a boot right into the painted face of Bronson. He's going to need to win this match just to get into a qualifier for the Elimination Chamber coming up at HKW Broken Hearts. Reverse DDT dropping down the Monster. Jason tossing Bronson into the ropes, spinning back elbow. And coming up next, Xander Shaw going to be meeting the newcomer to the HKW, JMAX. And that match will in fact be a qualifier match for the Elimination Chamber coming up at HKW Broken Hearts. Bronson locked back in that stranglehold by the Monster Jason. Bronson able to create separation, back to his feet, Russian leg sweep, taking the feet out from underneath the Monster. But quickly, Jason recovering, whipping the arm of Bronson, who fights off the shoulders of the Monster, whipping Jason into the corner, and oh! Shoulder of Jason slamming hard into that ring post. And now Bronson looking to do what he does best, and that is fly up to the top rope. Jason struggling to get back to his feet, and here comes Bronson. What a drop kick right to the chest of the Monster. Back to his feet, back down to his back. And a two count for Bronson. Right hand into the face of Jason. That doesn't even seem to faze this monster of a man. Can only imagine how devastating it would be for one of these kaijus to be inside the Elimination Chamber. Coming up at Broken Hearts. Jason just dominating. Here's a cover two, and up comes the shoulder of Bronson, keeping this thing alive. Jason, looking for that choke slam. Bronson fighting his way out of it, sending Jason over the top rope. Jason holding on and nope, going down just like he did this past Sunday. Bronson coming off the apron, looking to smash Jason, but Jason rolling out of the way and thrown hard into the steel steps here at ringside. Personally, ladies and gentlemen, I can't help but look forward to later on tonight when HKW Undisputed Women's Champion Scarlet Jones gets it on with the former Women's Champion, the Queen of the Elite, April Mead. No disqualification match for the Undisputed Women's Championship. That is still to come later on tonight. Jason fighting his way out of the Boston Crab at ringside. Six. Aaron Bronson heading back inside the ring, weary of the referee's 10 count. And here comes the monster, unrelenting. Oh! And once again, Aaron Bronson finding himself slammed hard onto his back. Jason looking for it, looked like he was going for a chokeslam. Bronson ducking underneath, but now a series of right hands into the face of Bronson, leveled in the corner. Oh! Bronson brought out hard with the bulldog dead center of the ring. This is not looking good for Aaron Bronson. Clubbing blows from the monster. Covered now by Jason. And again, somehow Bronson is still alive. Bronson, elbows to the side of the face of Jason, escaping the clutches of the choke slam. Sunset flip into the powerbomb. Pinning combination two and Jason. This time it's Jason forced to kick out and keep his hopes alive. Bronson looks like a man determined. Looks like he knows exactly what he's going for up on the top. Oh! No! Jason getting the knees up. Bronson going for that senton. But Jason got the knees up. Bronson dropping underneath, face buster. Back up to the top goes Bronson. Second time, gets it. Hooks the leg. One, two. That's going to do it. And Bronson picking up the win here on HKW Wednesday night. Triumphant return for Aaron Bronson, and that means next week Bronson will indeed get a qualifier match to enter the Elimination Chamber coming up at HKW Broken Hearts. Congratulations to Aaron Bronson. JMAX heading down to the ring, and this match will indeed be a qualifier match for the Elimination Chamber coming up at HKW Broken Heart. JMAX debuting in the Royal Gauntlet, and a lot of you guys didn't get to see it, but actually having a dark match with a fellow newcomer to the HKW, Justin Armstrong, facing off in tag team action against the Swolepocalypse. JMAX and Justin would be successful in that contest, but it really broke down afterwards. JMAX laying out Armstrong, and really showing something to the HKW Nation. That, of course, a Facebook exclusive contest. Go ahead and check out our Facebook page. Link is in the description, so you can go ahead and check out these two incredible newcomers here in HKW. Meanwhile, a man who I had to say I really thought he was going to pull it off. One of the final two men in the Royal Gauntlet match, Xander Shaw, coming within inches of capturing the HKW Championship this past Sunday. But when a door closes, a window opens, and that means that Xander Shaw gonna get a shot tonight to get inside that Elimination Chamber. And thus another shot at the HKW Championship. Collar elbow tie up here between JMAX and Xander Shaw. Shaw pushed back into the corner. Referee looking for a clean break. And oh! Well, Shaw's going to give it to him, but not JMAX. JMAX looking for a belly to belly. Shaw fighting out of it, looking for a clothesline of his own. A little bit of cat and mouse here between Shaw and JMAX in the early moments. JMAX flipping off of shoulders of the shoulder of Shaw, landing on his feet, picking up Shaw. High vertical suplex, just holding Shaw up there, letting all the blood just rush down into the head of the generic one, Xander Shaw. JMAX kicks into the side of Shaw. Irish whip, sending Shaw into the ropes. JMAX gonna drop down underneath. Now, leapfrogging over and a spinebuster planting Xander Shaw. And a quick cover followed by a quick one count for the newcomer, JMAX. And where did JMAX go? Really taking it to Shaw here. HKW Wednesday Night Prestige. For Shaw, former HKW champion, former internet champion, former social media champion. Oh! JMAX picked up and brought down hard on the back of his head, courtesy of Shaw. Making his way back to his feet, jawbreaker by JMAX. Drilling a knee into the gut of Shaw, and now taking that pad off the turnbuckle. Oh no, this is not looking good for Xander Shaw. Shaw diving in, catching JMAX. Submission applied to JMAX. Shaw brought back to his feet, Irish whip. Oh! Shaw crashing into that exposed metal ring in the corner. Straight to the spine. I can feel that just watching it. It's such an incredible opportunity for JMAX. If he was able to qualify for the Elimination Chamber here in his first outing on HKW Wednesday Night Prestige, especially against the talent, the caliber of Xander Shaw. Shaw drilling the knee into the side of JMAX, just starting to pick apart Mr. Explicit Content, looking for the elbow. JMAX rolling out of the way. And again, look at this strength on display by JMAX. Takes an incredible amount of upper body strength to hold a man the size of Xander Shaw up in that suplex position, especially for that long. Every second of which, blood rushing to the head of the generic one. He drops underneath JMAX and elevating him over the top rope. JMAX crashing down to the floor outside. Looked like Shaw was going for a vertical suplex of his own. JMAX, knee to the head of Shaw, and dropping Shaw down, package pile driver to Xander Shaw. What an incredible contest we are seeing here tonight on HKW Wednesday Night Prestige. Shaw trying to get up to his feet, and oh! Xander Shaw put down by the double underhook DDT from JMAX. Fortunately for him, that foot is rolling underneath the bottom rope. I've seen JMAX in action. That might have just been it for Xander Shaw, who now is going to lead JMAX into the corner. Shaw still looking a little out of sorts off the ropes, and going back to what he does so well, exploding with that shoulder tackle. Nothing generic about that shoulder tackle from Xander Shaw, able to get a pinfall, but only a one count here on JMAX. Knee into the face of JMAX, the second one for good measure. What a welcome to the HKW JMAX is getting right here tonight from Xander Shaw. Lifting JMAX up onto his shoulders. X marks the spot. Shaw slow to cover JMAX, and JMAX able to get the shoulder up this time. Shaw and JMAX exchanging some of their best moves here tonight, moves that have won their matches, championships. Really pushing each other to the limit here tonight on HKW Wednesday Night Prestige. Xander Shaw heading up to the top rope. JMAX rolling out to the floor, trying to seek some sanctuary. Gonna find none. Shaw connecting with the elbow, coming off that top rope. And now JMAX answering with the European uppercut. Has Shaw up, powerbomb taking him down, and rolling it into a Boston Crab on the outside. Shaw screaming in pain on the outside. These fans here in Tampa, Florida, really getting a treat. Is January too early to nominate a potential match of the year candidate? This is exactly what we are seeing here tonight. Incredible contest between JMAX and Xander Shaw. Kick to the midsection from JMAX, and both men making their way back inside the ring. A look of exhaustion. What do I have to do? written on the face of both men. JMAX planting Shaw with a spinebuster, and again, the shoulder of Shaw popping off the canvas. JMAX now heading up to the top rope. Xander Shaw breathing heavy on the mat. Here comes JMAX. Clothesline colliding with Xander Shaw. And he got 100% of that, ladies and gentlemen. Drop toehold now by JMAX. Hooking the head into the STF. Too close to the ropes. Good ring awareness by the former HKW champion Xander Shaw, taking down JMAX with the Russian leg sweep. Kick to the midsection and X-breaker! X-breaker from Xander Shaw! Pulling JMAX to the middle of the ring, and JMAX kicking out! Almost on pure instinct this time. Now JMAX telling him, let's go. JMAX wants more. Shaw happy to oblige. JMAX catching Shaw, Sambo suplex. Xander Shaw slipping out the back, coming out with a German suplex now. Suplexes being exchanged between JMAX and Xander Shaw. You can see frustration welling up on the face of Xander Shaw. Heads out to the floor. Kick right into the chest of JMAX. The generic one, Xander Shaw, and Mr. Explicit Content, JMAX. On the outside, JMAX flying the face of Shaw with the elbow. We're becoming a believer here in JMAX. Incredible Wednesday night prestige debut, slamming Shaw hard down onto the canvas. Shaw with a reversal. Shaw with a reversal out of nowhere, lifting up JMAX, modifying the X marks the spot. And discus clothesline, putting down JMAX. Dropping down, thought he was going for a cover instead. Xander Shaw. Look at the aggression from Xander Shaw. An aggressive streak that I would say we haven't seen out of Shaw in quite some time. Just roaring to life here. Shaw off the ropes. Oh! Xander Shaw running over JMAX, rolling him into the cover. One, two, that's gonna do it. Xander Shaw inking out a victory over JMAX here on HKW Wednesday Night Prestige. I don't even know if that's the real story. JMAX with an incredible debut here tonight over the former HKW champion Xander Shaw.
Here is your winner, Xander Shaw
will qualify for that Elimination Chamber match coming up at HKW Broken Hearts Meanwhile, we're going to try and catch up with the Alpha Angel, Brian Mead, who is on the hunt for Despair and the HKW Internet Championship. Well, it would appear that the Alpha Angel making his way down into the boiler room here in Tampa. Whoa, wait, that's Blake Buchanan. Where the hell did he come from? TWE's Blake Buchanan sneaking up on the Alpha Angel, Brian Mead. That is not who he was looking for down in the bowels of the building here tonight. And there is no one around to give any assistance to the Alpha Angel, Brian Mead. Oh my God! Blake Buchanan just destroying the Alpha Angel down in the boiler room.
Extreme Rules match. It is for the Undisputed Women's Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're getting ready for this. This huge title match here. I'm concerned with the health of these HKW superstars. First CJ Mundo, then Evan Jones, and now the Alpha Angel being attacked. We need to find out if the Alpha Angel is okay. And another woman who's no stranger to these attacks from TWE, the former HKW Undisputed Women's Champion. You wanna hear the longest reigning women's champion in HKW history. The Queen of the Elite, April Mead. April and Scarlet Jones having a classic this past Sunday at the HKW Royal Gauntlet. And we are getting a rematch of that contest here tonight. Of course, this time, we're going to turn the volume on up. There will be no disqualification here tonight. And as Hailstorm's Vicious plays out the HKW Undisputed Women's Champion, I have to imagine that is just what this contest is going to be. Not for the faint of heart here tonight on HKW Wednesday Night Prestige.
Introducing the challenger, from Detroit, Michigan, the Queen. And introducing the champion, from Battle Creek, Michigan, she's the Natural.
Scarlet Jones capturing the hearts of the HKW Nation. Tonight, going to be putting out that HKW Undisputed Women's Championship belt against a woman who knows what it is like to be the Undisputed Champion all too well, April Mead. Forced to relinquish the title after illness. It looked like she was going to be out of commission for quite some time, making a speedy recovery and back into an HKW ring, earning her opportunity back at the gold and getting another shot at it here tonight. Irish Whip sending Scarlet Jones over the top rope, and Scarlet tumbling down to the floor on the outside. Here comes April looking for the elbow. Scarlet rolling out of the way. Oh! April being slammed hard into those steel steps at ringside. There is no count out, no disqualification here. As April reasserts dominance in this contest, sidewalk slam taking down Scarlet Jones. April flinging Scarlet back inside the ring and taking a peek underneath the ring apron and pulling out a table that finds its way colliding with the head of Scarlet Jones. God only knows what April Mead has planned here tonight for Scarlet Jones, but it is 100% legal, whatever it is. And again, April tossing Scarlet back inside the ring. Whoa! And a second table being pulled out. Like, I don't know exactly what April has planned, but it is not going to be good for the HKW Undisputed Women's Champion. Scarlet Jones pops back to her feet. Crucifix taking down the Queen of the Elite, April Mead. Now Scarlet going to try and take advantage of one of those tables. Trying to bounce it in the corner. And seeing April coming up from behind, kicking the table out of the hands of April Mead. Nice move on the part of the women's champion. April shoving off. Scarlet has her up on her shoulder. Oh! Scarlet Jones face first. Just being slammed into those tables. Scarlet looks like she just had her dome rocked here as April Mead begins to do a little bit of housekeeping. Oh! And again, the hardware coming into the head of Scarlet Jones. And now April has these tables stacked up on top of each other. Doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out what Mead has in store. For Scarlet Jones, Scarlet fighting with everything she has to stay out of the clutches of April. Could be looking to send April through those tables right here. April fighting her way off the shoulders of the champ. Scarlet now elevated up onto the top turnbuckle. Oh no. And this could seal the fate for Scarlet Jones. April Mead has her up. Oh my God! Scarlet Jones drilled down through two tables. And somehow Scarlet Jones kicking out at two. April looking for the famous are caught by Jones. The toughness of Scarlet Jones on display. And now Scarlet, steel chair to the back of the head of April Mead. And who said these ladies can't get hardcore? April Mead forced to kick out at two after a wicked chair shot from Scarlet Jones. Scarlet ducking underneath, connecting with the lariat as April back on her feet. April sending Scarlet back to her back with a fireman's carry and lifting her up, dropping her back down to the sidewalk with that slam. Now it's April. It's April with that steel chair. Wedging it in the corner. Oh! Hard kick to the gut of Scarlet Jones, who reverses
The Irish whip sending April careening into that steel chair. And now Scarlet grabbing a hold of a baseball bat. April not just going to let her have that, though. Famous are coming down from the former women's champ. And a two count for the Queen of the Elite. And here comes Scarlet Jones once again. Kick into the chest of April Mead, who rolls out to the floor. We've had tables, we've had chairs. How about some ladders now? April Mead pulling out a ladder. And oh no, another table. Scarlet Jones doesn't want to be the victim of being put through another table here. April trying to create some separation, but Scarlet quickly back to her feet. And now heading back inside the ring is the HKW Undisputed Women's Champion, Scarlet Jones, grabbing a hold of that ladder. But April's got the table. Oh my God! And now fire erupting from that table. Wait! Oh my God! That's literally one! Oh! TWE's Leone just bringing down April Mead. And this is such a dangerous environment. Wait, there's Dragon Queen with a steel chair to the Undisputed Women's Champion, Scarlet Jones, who had set up that ladder inside the ring. Oh! Scarlet Jones crashing down as Lenora Lynn destroying April Mead at ringside. A huge elbow crashing down. Oh no. Oh no, we've seen this out of Team TWE before! April Mead! No! Come on, no! No! Oh my God! April Mead! Superplex off the top through that burning table at ringside! This is heinous! Oh no, and now Dragon Queen with Scarlet Jones. What is Dragon Queen planning here? Up on the apron, has Scarlet Jones draped down? Oh! Driving the leg into the back of Scarlet Jones. Check this out. Wow! The athleticism of the Dragon Queen. We need some help out here. This is... Oh my God! I
seen some souls be friendly. I've seen some feet get loose. I've had some people in my life who know just what it do. I try to look for goodness even when I see bad. I've seen some souls be friendly. I've seen some feet get loose. I've had some people in my life who know just what it do. I try to look for goodness even when I see bad. We'll be right back.
There you see Michael Scars Minor and JMAX in the backstage area. I'm not sure what that is all about. Nevertheless, ladies and gentlemen, I have some exciting news. After all these attacks by TWE, HKW management, gonna do something about it. Gonna do something about it here tonight. We are going to have ourselves a six-man tag team match. Corey Tombstone, Blake Buchanan, and the demonic clown known as Zelzebub gonna be taking on the B-Fed Elite, Chris Chaos, Alpha Angel, Brian Mead, and Michael Scars Minor. On his way down to the ring, he is the innovator of Scottish Strong Style, Ian King. Ian King earning himself an HKW contract with a victory over other hopeful Nick Bruiser, making his official HKW in-ring debut at the Royal Gauntlet. Actually did very well inside the gauntlet, especially for his first HKW Royal Gauntlet matchup. But here tonight, he's gonna have a hard row to hoe as he is going to be taking on the HKW United States Champion, Rock Leone,
at 220 pounds, one half of the Rock Leone.
At Royal Gauntlet, Rock Leone put the United States title on the line against Xander Shaw and Aaron O'Connor. An incredibly hard-fought battle. All three men taking it to the limit. But in the end, Rock Leone taking advantage, hitting that rock drop. I think up the 1-2-3, maintaining his run as HKW United States Champion. My brand just increased the profits. Let the dirt sheets gossip, I'm the new hot topic. You know what time it is when the clock starts ticking. The wood grain gripping, ball was still tipping. Of course, Ian King, no rookie inside a squared circle indeed. Ian King has been all over the world displaying his talents, now bringing them here to the HKW. Here we go. These Tampa fans erupting on the bell for this contest between Rock Leone and Ian King. Leone quickly establishing some control with a bulldog. Oh, maybe I spoke too soon. The innovator of Scottish Strong Style quickly turning things around again. Grabbing the arm of Rock Leone, and now a headlock, taking Rock Leone down to the mat. Rock Leone fighting back to his feet, and a dragon whip putting down Ian King. Oh, look at that. Ian King spun around on his heel, clothesline from Rock Leone. Rock gonna take a kick to the midsection, and now Ian following up, dropping the elbow hard into the chest of Rock Leone. That's the thing about every one of these strikes from Ian King, there is no give. It's like a log smashing into your chest every time that this guy hits you with a knife-edge chop. It reversal on the Irish whip from the United States Champion. Rock Leone looking to inflict some punishment of his own, bringing Ian King out of the corner with a modified powerbomb. Ian King doesn't even seem fazed. Oh, and that is what I'm talking about right there. like a baseball bat right into your ribs. Rock Leone trying to slow things down here after that clubbing blow from Ian King into the chest of Leone. And oh, look at and the speed of Rock Leone flying past Ian King before he can land the drop kick. And it's going to be up to Leo to keep that midsection intact, as too many of those huge blows, you know, from Ian King can damage your ribs, make it very hard to breathe, and thus make it very hard to compete inside a wrestling ring. Rock Leone again. Reversal of the Irish whip, and now climbing on top of Ian King. The encouragement of these fans here in Tampa, Florida. King forcing Leone off them out of the corner, but Leone keeping on the offensive. Good move by the United States champion. Twists underneath and DDT to Ian King. A stun gun to boot, courtesy of the HKW United States Champion. Ian King gonna answer back, big elbow, and oh! Drung a shoulder into the midsection, sending Rock Leone off the ring apron and down into the barrier here at ringside. And here goes Ian King, kicks and stomps into that midsection, those ribs of Rock Leone. Almost like all the offense just designed to rip apart the midsection of the United States champion. Leone breaking the referee's 10 count, back out to the floor, picking up Ian King and dropping King onto his back.
Four.
Rock is going to have to find some way to slow down this offense.
Five.
From the innovator of Scottish strong style, Ian Six. King. Oh, that is a good equalizer right there. King sent face first into the ring post, now brought back in. Leone telling these fans that he has a plan. Oh! I'm sure that plan didn't involve getting caught and slammed down by Ian King. Ian hooking the head of Rock. Rock now rolling out to the floor. Just trying, you can see him gasping for breath.
Two.
After this attack.
Three.
From King. Oh! Steel steps, not a bad equalizer out here on the floor.
Four.
Referees count up to five. These guys are going to have to get back in the ring.
Six.
Of course, it might be safer for both men if they don't. King and Leone battling it out here on HKW Wednesday Night Prestige in this non-title contest. King, first one back to his feet, and now he's got Leone. Oh, burning hammer!
One, two,
covered by the King and a kick out by Leone. Ian King now hooking the arms of Rockland. Oh! Look at this move. Double underhook pile driver from Ian King to Rock Leone. That's gonna do it. Whoa. Hey, calm it down. Ian King hopping off of Rock Leone, and now gonna pick him up again. Oh! And this is enough. Ian King taking this from a friendly contest to unsportsmanlike conduct very quickly. Oh, come on. Oh, a third one. Rock Leone being just decimated here by Ian King. Dropping down on my own. And that's going to do it. Ian King going to be awarded the victory after a good match with a very violent end. I personally hope that Rock Leone is okay after that vicious assault from Ian King.
Here is your winner, Ian E.
Ladies and gentlemen, get ready. Six-man tag team action is up next. Team TWE against the E-Fed Elite. And here we go, on their way to the ring.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 735 pounds, the Entourage.
E-Fed Elite making their way down here through the fans. You see the HKW Chaos Champion, Christopher Chaos, Michael Scars Minor, and the Alpha Angel was attacked earlier tonight down in the boiler room by Blake Buchanan. And I am receiving word that HKW Commissioner Aaron O'Connor has made the ruling that the Alpha Angel Brian Mead and Chaos Champion Christopher Chaos will be awarded spots inside the Elimination Chamber coming up at Broken Hearts. Not exactly fair, if you ask me. Guess that's what happens when you loop the commissioner into being in league with you. And I gotta say that I have not been a fan of the E-Fed Elite for quite some time. I have not cheered for the E-Fed Elite in quite some time, but here tonight, go get him, E-Fed Elite! On his way down to the ring, a vile snake and a disgusting human being, if you ask me, who not only attacked the Alpha Angel earlier tonight, but also is partially responsible for injuring the former HKW champion, the longest reigning champion we ever had here in the HKW, Evan Jones. And Evan, wherever you are, I want to wish you a speedy recovery. Get back here in the HKW quick,
because
your friends are going to need you if they're going to continue to deal with TWE guys like Blake Buchanan or this guy, the ringleader, Corey Tombstone. If you're wondering why I'm not talking, my mom always told me if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. So I just thought I'd let you all just watch Corey Tombstone head into the ring.
And their partner, from parts unknown, weighing in at 220 pounds, Wildman.
Well, there's the demon clown Zelzibar, who we saw also assist Blake Buchanan and Corey Tombstone this past Sunday at the Royal Gauntlet, coming out and stopping the Alpha Angel from assisting Evan Jones as Buchanan and Corey Tombstone had their way with the former HKW champion. There's something just extra creepy about Zelzibar, and I don't think it's just because he's a clown. I think it might be because he's from TWE. Not entirely certain. Nevertheless, this match is underway. Michael Scar is minor, going to immediately tag out to the Alpha Angel. And Angel more than happy to get in the ring with Blake Buchanan. Of course, Michael Scar's minor in action this past Sunday, challenging Daniel Roberts for the World Heavyweight Championship over on Rampage. Michael Scar is putting on a tremendous effort, incredible match between those two. If you have not already seen that contest, you need to go and check that out. It was amazing. Alpha Angel fighting back. Blake Buchanan into the corner, shoots him into the ropes. And here comes Buchanan. Scooping up Angel. Angel dropping off the shoulders of Buchanan, going after TWE's heavy and throwing him over with a snap suplex. Here comes the HKW Chaos Champion, Chris Chaos. And Chaos gonna catch a drop kick right to the jaw from Buchanan, following it up with a senton right to the body of Christopher Chaos. Scooping up Chaos, cross the legs, dropping down Chaos with the knee breaker as Scars and Angel look on. There goes Buchanan, thrown over the top, courtesy of Christopher Chaos, putting that hard head of his to good use with the headbutt to the shoulder of Buchanan. And Buchanan airlifted over the top rope, belly to belly, courtesy of the HKW Chaos Champion, the enforcer of the EFED Elite, Christopher Chaos, not going to keep Buchanan down for long. Here goes Buchanan off the ropes, and another senton. Christopher Chaos getting worked over here by Team TWE. Oh! Scars and Angel calling out to Chaos, trying to encourage their teammate. And for what? Oh! Buchanan tagging Michael Scars Minor, Angel tagging himself in. And that may not have been a wise choice for the Alpha Angel, Brian Mead. Fights his way out of the collar elbow tie-up, but the strength of Buchanan too much. Snake eyes for the Alpha Angel. Michael Scars Minor, Brian Mead, and Christopher Chaos all working like a well-oiled unit. And now Blake Buchanan tagging out to Zalzabar. Angel diving off the top rope, catching Zalzabar, the dark clown, with a bit of that crossbody. I don't know how much he caught out of it. Bringing the clown to his feet, Irish whip, sending Zalzabar into the corner. Putting with a splash, Zalzabar moving out of the way. Angel back up to his feet. And now Angel, belly to back, putting Zalzabar down onto the canvas once again. Good moves on the part of the Alpha Angel. Brian meets Snapmare, flipping over the top of Zalzabar. And now a drop kick right to the painted face of the clown. You can hear Corey Tombstone cheering on Zalzabar. But I don't know if any amount of cheering is going to help this. The Alpha Angel has the clown up. Oh, one-winged angel. One-winged angel putting down Zalzabar. And now the Alpha Angel summoning in Christopher Chaos and Michael Scars Minor. They've got the clown up, and down he goes! The Ethan Elite slamming down Zalzabar with a triple powerbomb. Blake Buchanan in to save things for TWE Alpha Angel. With a right hand, dropping Buchanan off of the apron. Here comes Zalzabar. Back to his feet, kick to the back of Mead. Angel twisting down underneath Zalzabar. Irish whip sending Zalzabar into the corner. And a tag, whoa! What the hell is this? Michael Scars Minor walking out on the Ethan Elite. What the hell? Minor walking out on the Ethan Elite. Corey Tombstone getting the tag, and all of a sudden, the Alpha Angel and Chris Chaos finding themselves in a two-on-one handicap situation. This is exactly what you gotta imagine the TWE team wanted here tonight. Zalzabar slamming down the Alpha Angel Falcon Arrow. Tag in to Blake Buchanan. Angel off the ropes, drop to hold, elbow drop from Buchanan into the back. Angel just trying to get to his feet, and chokehold locked in by Buchanan. And here comes Chaos, breaking up the hold. Angel headbutt into the nose of Buchanan, back to his feet. Angel and Chaos not gonna quit, but they have quite the uphill battle here. Oh! As Angel again getting dropped down hard onto his back, fighting off the shoulder of Buchanan. Blake rolling through, drop toe hold, dropping Angel face first. Buchanan ripping apart the Alpha Angel. Brian Mead desperately trying to get Chris Chaos to make a tag, but there may be no help coming for the Alpha Angel. Oh! Blake Buchanan driving the Alpha Angel hard down into the mat. Here's the cover. Two. And Angel! Angel kicks out! The heart of the Alpha Angel still beating here on Wednesday Night Prestige. Brought back to his feet, and reversal on the Irish whip. A cross chop for Blake Buchanan. Angel not just speaking for himself to eat Fatty Leap, but the entire HKW Nation on that one. Up to the top rope now with Buchanan. Superplex! Superplex! Taking down Blake Buchanan. Buchanan up to his feet, shot to the midsection on the Alpha Angel. Angel, kick to the gut on Buchanan. And a big right hand laying down Buchanan. Angel taking a knee, not able to follow up. He knows he's got to stay in there as long as he can. Let Chris Chaos recoup as much strength in this now handicapped environment. Buchanan, multiple slaps to the face of the Alpha Angel. Angel elevating hard into the corner. Buchanan mocking Chaos. Angel diving to Chaos. Chaos getting the tag. Drop kick from Christopher Chaos. Snapmare takeover. Christopher Chaos taking control away from Blake Buchanan. Elbows now into the chest of Buchanan, who pops back up to his feet. Forearm shimmy from Buchanan. And now Buchanan going to take Chaos up onto the top. And I don't know if Angel's going to be any more help in this contest. Blake Buchanan has Christopher Chaos off the top rope, twisting down into a Falcon Arrow. Zelzibar and Corey Tombstone up on the ring apron, mocking the enforcer of the EFED Elite, Christopher Chaos. Chaos turning things around, sending Buchanan hard into the corner. Buchanan. Oh! And Buchanan laying out both members of the EFED Elite here. And a tag in to the ringleader, Corey Tombstone. Tombstone just in here picking up the pieces now. Oh no. Christopher Chaos picked up by all team TWE. Triple powerbomb. The Elite Enforcer laid out. The Alpha Angel drilled off the side of the apron. Oh no. Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Corey Tombstone grabbing a table. Oh! Shot to the face on Chaos. Gets tossed back into the ring. Chaos can't even get back to his feet. This 3-on-2 assault from Team TWE. Just laying waste to the Ifed Elite here. Tag into the clown. Send in the clowns. Here comes Zelzebar. No! Christopher Chaos! Shot to the midsection, Zelzebar! Zelzebar fighting back! And Chaos! Set careening over that top rope, courtesy of a clothesline by Zelzebar. Zelzebar gonna take advantage of that table out at ringside. Big DDT. Zelzebar bringing the table into the ring and taking the legs out from underneath the Alpha Angel. Just in case he thought he might be coming to aid Chris Chaos. I don't think there's gonna be any such luck here tonight in Tampa, Florida. The clown in complete control has Christopher Chaos up! Dead center of the ring, a powerbomb! Drilling Chaos through the table, 2, 3, he can't get there in time! Corey Tombstone driving a shoulder into the face of the Alpha Angel just before he got there. And TWE gonna walk away victorious here tonight from Wednesday Night Prestige. This makes me sick. Wait, what? What? Oh my God! Here are your, ladies and gentlemen, make sure that you don't miss Wednesday Night Prestige next week. I've just been informed our main event is gonna be Corey Tombstone versus Aaron Bronson. Qualifier match for the Elimination Chamber. You're not going to want to miss it. We'll see you for Rampage. I've been Richard G. Mayer. Good night, everybody.